Well, hello there, everybody, and welcome back to Epic Fail or Win, the weekly show where we take a look at the free Epic games every single week and figure out not if they're worth your money, but if they're worth your time. And here we have Brotato. And we are once again in one of those weeks where we have a game that I do not know. I don't know this game. I haven't even heard of this game before, and I'd figure this would be one of those games that I'd have heard about based on the style, but nope. One of the things that's interesting is I'm pretty sure this game, because I tested it yesterday, and I'm pretty sure this game did show my mouse on screen when I did. This time, however, it is not showing my mouse on screen. So we're gonna just jump in here with a controller and then try to use the mouse afterwards. All right, so we got runs, we got an endless run, got co-op, but no co-op here. Now I don't even, oh, there we go. I don't even know what type, well, you know, the endless run option kind of implies a type of game, but all right, so well-rounded, minus 50 range, crazy, ranger, mage, there's a lot. You know what, let's keep it boring, you know, just harvesting. Okay, interesting. Ooh, all right. Precise, primitive, fist. Cacti club. Ghost flint. So, let's see, we got just a gun. Yeah, I'll probably take the gun, thank you. I do like that the SMG is just the pistol, but just with more of a clip. Ooh, I do like shotguns. Yeah, okay, we're just gonna, sorry to everybody who, he's like screaming like, why would you pick that? You have no idea what this game is. And you're right, I have no idea what this game is. So we're just gonna jump in. Oh, okay, yep, there you go. So this is a automatic shooter. We're just gonna, oh no. Now, the only thing here is, because I don't have control and it just, so it automatically, so it's an auto shooter in that sense, or at least I think it is. And because it automatically shoots, you know, what is this? What do you call this genre again? This endless runner type genre? Like technically, this is, would be in the same genre as whatever Vampire Survivors is in, because this is even how Vampire, you know, this is exactly how Vampire Survivors works. So is this a, I don't want to talk down to the game and say it's a Vampire Survivors clone, but is this a game influenced by how big a deal Vampire Survivors was, which is a game I love, you know, to be clear. Okay, yep, there you go. So that's probably why you shouldn't. So, okay, now that I know that it's similar to Vampire Survivors, this maybe makes more sense, is that then you have, you know, more stuff. Now, I got 49. So I'm just going to pick another ranged weapon here. And then, you know what? Why not? Now, I know why not is what you're going to say. So something that's interesting is, so just like in Vampire Survivors, I think, wait, no, sorry. Not like Vampire Survivors. I'm thinking of a different game now. But you move, when you move, the stuff works faster, which I don't think is how Vampire Survivors works, but now I'm questioning my knowledge of Vampire Survivors. I've beaten Vampire Survivors for the record, but now I suddenly am getting nervous about like, oh, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe it didn't, I don't know. You know, I'm gonna keep upgrading these lungs and the crossbow. Does this upgrade the crossbow or? I don't know. Lightning shiv. Why not? You know, I don't know what I'm doing here, so. So the automatically, I don't know how I feel about the automatic aiming, because I definitely feel like it could mess you up. Though, why would I think that it's fine in a game like Vampire Survivors and not this? I don't know. I guess it's because of the melee, or the whatchamacallit, the nature of Vampire Survivors is just that is such that like you know exactly where you know exactly where your weapon is going to be going to, right? Whereas here your guy is automatically aiming those at people. Like, he's automatically aiming it at the next guy. Which I don't really like, I guess. Like, I prefer the Vampire Survivors way of like, oh, like, I am... Like I know, based on what this weapon is, what it is going to do. You know, I know where this weapon is going to aim, and then I'm upgrading it, but, like... I'm always positioning myself. Like, think about the whip in Vampire Survivors, for example, right? Like, you know where the whip is gonna go. You know how the whip works, how it's gonna aim, and all of those things. And it makes it, I don't know, like that to me is like part of what makes Vampire Survivors so good. Combine that with the fact that this is in, like, okay, I feel bad because I'm just gonna be comparing this to Vampire Survivors a lot and saying what I think Vampire Survivors is better. I think Vampire Survivors not having waves is also a big part, though perhaps if I were to play the endless mode, it would work the exact same way as Vampire Survivors works normally. So that I don't think that's a real criticism in that sense as I bring that up. So, you know, just worth pointing that out for the record. Attack speed, please. Range, lifesteal, armor. Let's do... Keep that lifesteal going. Claw tree, knife, jousting lance. I don't know what this is. I'm gonna do it. My man's eyes are looking a little strange. But yeah, like, I think the thing that I like about Vampire Survivors is that you are in many ways just trying to make yourself invincible. Like, this is not literally the case, but like in many cases, it's like, oh, I'm just trying to make it so that I can walk into guys and they die. Whereas here, I am, you know, still avoiding very specifically, though soon enough, I am sure I'm not going to be able to avoid for much longer. And there's going to be enough guys that I'm going to have to work a little harder. Item found, mutation. I don't know. Yeah, sure. Why not? I want more damage. Thank you. Ooh, a shuriken. Ooh, a cute monkey. Ooh, that's a monkey. I want to murder, though, so I'm going to do that. So, if I were to buy another weapon now... Oh, that's not a weapon, though. All right, well, let's see if weapons ever come back up again to buy. All right. Yeah, like... I'm not getting much upgrades. Also, can I just stand still? Like, kind of, but not really. Like, yeah, no, not, sort of. We can, you know, we let's see. Let's see if we can... No, okay, no, we're not yet at the point where we can stand still. Because, you know, a few more enemies than that, and we'd have gotten completely overwhelmed there, so... So, yeah, I don't know, like, I feel bad comparing it to Vampire Survivors so much, but the thing that I will say, I don't know why I just said that, as though I was about to say something positive. I'm not about to say something positive. I don't like how the game looks. So I don't know why I started that by saying, like, so I will say, and then here comes a compliment, and then I say, I don't like how the game looks. And to be fair, that is entirely an aesthetic thing, so, you know... If you like the kind of Binding of Isaac style Newgrounds look, hey, there you go. You'll like this a lot, I think. It's just not for me. I love... It's tough, right? Because I love Vampire Survivors. I love Vampire Survivors. So, do I... Can I... Oh, I can recycle. So, which one should I recycle? Which one is the worst one that I got going? I'm gonna recycle that one and buy those. And let's see how it goes. Whoa, did you just boom? I like how that sounds. Like the thunk. So yeah, we cannot just stand still. So I think one of the things we definitely need to try before we finish here is just see if the endless mode is endless in terms of, is it still like this small of a map, or is it endless in the sense of just that the waves kind of keep coming and then you're upgrading. That's the thing we sort of need to figure out, because the big open maps is another thing that I really like about Vampire Survivors. Like, to be clear, I think this game is a different, like, obviously it's a similar game, but I do think there is a similar skill set here. And what I mean by that, engineering, what exactly does that mean? We might be thinking about other stuff in a second here. But what I mean is, I think what you are building yourself up to be able to do here is a little different to Vampire Survivors. I do not think they are directly equatable games in terms of the way in which you're playing them, you know, different mindset, different style. So, you know, I don't think if you like Vampire Survivors, but you think you wouldn't like this, that is the end of that argument. I do think they are different enough in terms of the style of what it is you're going for, maybe the way that you're going to build and blah, 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 that, you know, maybe there's something you'll get out of this that, nullifies the damage of one hit taken every wave. That's all right. So
you can't upgrade.
Oh, I can combine though. Oh, it's combined to get double crossbow. Interesting. All right, let's any of these that I can combine? No. All right, hopefully that means now that we've opened that up that we get more weapons. See, the problem is like, even though I don't like this game as much as Vampire Survivors, and you know, it feels silly to keep harping on that, and I'm sorry, but I'm still enjoying this. I still think this style of gameplay is very fun, very engaging. So, you know, to be clear, even though I've said some criticisms here, I think I should be absolutely clear on the fact that I like this style of gameplay. So, you know, if you do as well, and you know, you have fully completed, you know, there's and this is like, you know, you haven't played this one and you've played a bunch of games like this and you really like them, hey, there's another one here for you. You know what I mean? Like, do it up. Like, have fun, you know? Like, why wouldn't you? You know, it's free, and it's gonna give you all of those pieces that you've been enjoying in the other stuff. Ooh. Thank you. So we can't combine those though. That's interesting. So let's recycle you then. And then we're gonna grab a tool. And then maybe regret that. I don't know. Alright. Let's see. How powerful are we now? Alright. Yeah, look. We're starting to get a little bit of this, like, don't have to move. Oh. Is this gonna be the... I'm gonna stay still until we get hit here. See how long we can go for. Okay, yeah, these big guys are nobody's joke. They remind me of the swarms in the game that I'm not gonna say the name of again. Yeah, it's cool. And you know what's funny is I'm totally content to just keep sitting here and doing this. But, and if you've ever played one of these games, I think you'll feel for me here, but I'm just gonna have to quit and switch mode here. And it always feels so, I don't know, I want to show you more of how deep these go, but I think I should also leave that for you to discover in a lot of sense. So I hope that there's some cool stuff to discover. And if you've been playing this game and you know about this game, like, let me know, like, what is, like, you know, what are some of the really cool things you could do later? Like, one of the great ideas that comes with these sorts of games is being able to combine stuff into other stuff, and, like, you know, that changing what your build is, and, you know, all that stuff. Like, there's a lot of depth, and it's not even hidden depth. It's like, you know, it's mechanically always interesting. I'm going to return to the main menu, and then we're gonna. Oh, interesting! It'll let you resume that. That's good. All right, so we're gonna go endless. And then 50% attack speed with unarmed. Ooh. So what if we, let's try, you know, we just tried a character that was very much about shooting. So let's try this. So harvesting. All right, well, give me the fist. Now I'm gonna play with mouse and keyboard. That is very funny looking, and I'm very into it, and I'm proud of you, video game. I'm very proud of you right now. I'm not kidding. Like, this is not a joke. Like, look at how fucking sick this looks. Sorry for swearing. Wow. I'm very into what I just saw. Now, lifesteal is gonna be even better while we're close, but, you know, the melee damage. All right, so we got fist, so we could double up our fist. Butterfly, so we can afford another fist. Exploding range, it counts as melee. So let's do that. And then combine. And then I guess we still have two fists. I kind of want to do the... Okay, we don't have enough money anyway, so let's just go to the thing. So this is an endless mode that isn't quite doing what I wanted it to do. But, you know, we still needed to look at it to find out. Like, I was hoping that it was just going to, you know, have the more open map and then just be more of, you know, you being interrupted by the level ups and stuff like that. But that's not what we're getting here either, so... you know, it's definitely worth figuring out. It was definitely, you know, worth seeing and finding out for ourselves. Shuriken, no, we are a melee. The alien tongue is interesting. Let's do that. 7% damage for... or I think that knockback. Oh, look at the tongue. Look at that. I do like the way it affects how your character looks. I don't think we really need to we don't really need to move anymore. Here's the thing I will say about this game that makes me very excited. There is an ability. There is or an opportunity, a possibility that you can just have six hands, and those six hands are just punching at super fast speeds. And I think that is really cool. And for the first time today, let me say, is something that you cannot do in Vampire Survivors. So big ups to Brotato for having the ability to have potentially six hands just slapping around is I think awesome. I think that's so cool. This will also be melee, right? So let's go with another melee weapon. And then, yeah, I'll take a little lemonade. Thank you. Yeah, I'm enjoying this. I like, you know. Oh, how dare you? Oh, 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 we're starting to become a little bit of a monster there. The thing that I want to know is if you're a you know, you're a player of this game, you've been playing this game a lot, have you ever done the six hand build? Have you ever become, you know, the god of punching, the wrath of Asura, and just absolutely late into this game. How does it look? What's going on? I'm very curious. The crit chance. Now, the crit chance you're probably going to want later, but let's go with this for now. So we got luck, regeneration, speed. I'm going to go that regeneration. Now, screwdriver is also melee. There we go. Why not? Now, the only thing is I kind of need to get rid of the fist in order to get more weapons, right? So I kind of got to do that in advance, don't I? Which is too bad. Interesting. I don't think I don't remember the mines being there on the previous one. All right, this is kind of cool because now if we get overwhelmed, we can just move up to the left and blow everybody up. Or not. It blew up already because we punched at. Oh, I guess the guy probably ran into it, to be fair. So these guys, you do actually have to chase after, which if you're doing a ranged build, you wouldn't have to chase after them, right? Because they would have to come within your range anyway. Boxing glove. Thou saidst to me. Stick combine. Yes, sir. All right. I don't really know if there's much more that we can, say about this here. These guys are a little tricky, actually, because they are initially out of your range a little bit when they come in, these snail guys. So again, like, there is a little bit more of a positioning. There's a few more mechanics important to, like, how you position yourself. You know, it's not just quite about building a death machine. Like, it still is that, to be fair, but it's not quite as much that as some of these other games end up being, where it's just like, I am now, if you come anywhere close to me, you are going to burn up, and there's nothing that you can do about it, and, you know, this game is going to go for 30 minutes of me standing here, which is very cool and satisfying in its own way, but, you know, is not necessarily, why not? But is not necessarily anything else. Now, that's pretty cool. Now, the only thing that I would wonder, let's do a reroll here and see what we get. Ooh, hello. No! Oh, and we can't even sell them for enough. Oh. That seems like a cool thing. Anyway. Our guy is looking a little weird at this point. So we should go stand near the turret and then just, let's just stand here and see how it goes. So I'm just gonna stand here, and if I die, if he dies, he dies, you know? But let's see how the lifesteal does as well, in terms of how much health we're losing versus how much life we're gaining. So we're getting one relatively, what is that? Like every like 10 kills, let's say, we're getting one. So assumedly that's like every, how many seconds do we think that is? So yeah, so you can't do that. You can't do that. You gotta move. You know, you gotta move. You gotta make sure you are understanding the mechanics of the enemies that you're fighting against. And, you know, they will be just outside your range if you're melee only, and absolutely do you in. So, you know, worth pointing out, worth seeing. I think this is pretty cool. I love this type of game. Hey, guess what? You can get it right now for free. And, you know, that's always going to be pretty sick. Now, the thing that I can't really tell you anything about is the mod support. And I also don't really want to press on it either, because it'll probably take me somewhere else anyway. So I'm just gonna leave that alone. We're gonna leave that as a mystery for you to solve, for you to tell me about, perhaps. You know, have you been playing this game? What would you describe this genre as? Because it's not really an endless runner, an endless destroyer. Like, I don't know. Like, what is this genre called? What's your favorite game in this genre? Have you been playing this? How far does it go? Like, what kind of weapons can you get? Like, can you do the Full Asura's Wrath thing that I'm thinking about? Let me know in the comments down below. Thank you for support, as always. It's been great seeing everybody new coming into the channel, talking about stuff. Great comments. Great comment, actually, last week about... I'm trying to remember the name of the game. Yeah, not Enforcer. Oh, I'm blanking. Beholder? Behold, Beholder. Brotato and Beholder. And great comment where someone pointed out that they... To fix the game... because people weren't able to play it on Epic, in order to fix it, they had to roll it back to a previous version that has game-breaking bugs in it. And I think comments like that are so great, because like that is something that I could not have known about in advance. Like, you know, I would have to know exactly what to look for in that sense. But someone pointing that out is really useful information that, you know, can then make sure is high up in the comments. So thank you for that. Thank you for continuing to do that. Thank you for the continued support. I hope you have a great weekend or great week wherever you are, wherever you are and whatever you're doing. Thank you for joining me, folks, and I will hopefully see all of you in the next one. Bye-bye.